There are cocktails named after it. Walk into almost any bar in the country and you'll find a bottle up on the shelf. It's America's classic Tennessee whiskey, Jack Daniel's.
We're kind of a one focus town, but that makes for a great whiskey.
You can't go far in Lynchburg, Tennessee without seeing this legendary name. And every drop comes from this tiny town in Moore County. Ironically, a county that's been completely dry since Prohibition.
The distilleries of America are located, most of them are in Kentucky and Tennessee, and that's because we have limestone soils and mineral content that's vital in the fermentation process. So that's what brought Jack here.
It was here that Lutheran minister Dan Call taught a young Jasper Newton Daniels, nicknamed Jack, to make Tennessee-style whiskey. And the rest is history.
If you look at our employees today, so many of them are not just first generation. They've actually learned how to make whiskey from their parents and their grandparents.
Before earning the name Jack Daniel's, this whiskey in the making goes through five key areas: fermentation, distillation, charcoal mellowing, and barreling. But first, you need water, and only the purest will do.
So what is this?
This is the cave spring, and it provides us ample water for our fermentation process.
It feels very cool in here.
Kevin Smith has been Jack Daniel's quality control manager for 10 years.
What makes this water perfect for Jack Daniel's?
It's iron-free. It represents that we have the right nutritional balance in the water for the yeast.
Jack Daniel's can only be made in America because this is the water. This is
the one location, correct. Yeah.
The natural spring water gets cooked with rye, malted barley, and corn to make mash. Then the cooked mash heads here to the fermentation room.
That smell is amazing. It smells kind of like beer or bread. Can I taste it?
Go ahead.
My hands are clean, don't worry.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh. Very sweet, isn't it?
It tastes so good. It doesn't look that good, but it tastes amazing.
It's the sweetness that comes from converting those starches in the grains into simple sugars that you can taste. And it's also what the yeast then use to convert into Jack Daniel's whiskey.
I can taste it already.
In just 12 hours, the action inside the fermenter gets intense as yeast feeds on sugars in the mash and converts them to alcohol and CO2.
Oh.
Quite a bit of CO2 coming out of those.
So that's just CO2?
That's just CO2. A lot of people will look at a fermenter and they think it's actually boiling, but that temperature is only about 78 degrees.
But it's obviously the reaction of the elements.
The release of the CO2, and it's just rising to the top and bubbling off.
It's definitely releasing. I think my eyeballs just burned.
But Mother Nature could only take this whiskey so far. It's time for some pyrotechnics. It's a process called charcoal mellowing. It's what gives Jack its distinctive smooth taste, even before aging in barrels. But at Jack Daniel's, you don't get charcoal from just anywhere. You make your own.
Whoa.
You start with locally grown sugar maple and fire. But you have to light it with a very specific fuel.
Yes, sir.
Darren Lippum and Tracy Matlock fill me in on the secret.
Yes, sir. It's a 140 proof whiskey from our stills here at Jack Daniel's.
Oh, you use the whiskey to start the fire?
Yes.
So you...
We don't use any petroleum product or anything because it'd contaminate the charcoal.
Sure. So it makes sense. You sort of keep it in the family, you know, the family of flavors and tastes, right?
Start out with the whiskey.
That's very smart. How does this thing work? Can I do that?
Yes, sir.
Can I spray some white lightning?
Yeah.
No, I'm going to spray it right here.
Oh, I see. Oh, wow. Oh!
Next, the unmatured whiskey and homemade charcoal meet here in the mellowing room.
This is 140 proof. This was what we saw coming flowing through the still.
Through the still.
Earlier today, it will come over and basically come through one of 72 vats. They're all 10 feet in depth.
This is 10 feet deep?
Yeah.
It was 10 feet of packed charcoal.
It is, hand-packed by our own employees.
How long does it take this whiskey to drip from here and appear on the other side of this 10 feet down?
It's safe to say that it'll take days. This corn that you can smell here, there'll be no evidence of that at the bottom. But this is what comprises a Tennessee whiskey. This one step is the reason why we're not a bourbon.
From here, the mellowed whiskey goes to barreling. Jack Daniel's builds each white oak barrel from scratch. charring the inside to caramelize the wood's natural sugars, giving Jack its rich color and flavor. Finally, each one's filled with 60 gallons of whiskey and trucked to the barrel house for aging. Now, with the whiskey in barrels, it's time to try my hand at barrel rolling. This is Barrel Central. It's a super secure seven-story building that houses over 20,000 barrels of Jack Daniels. And the only way to get these barrels onto the racks is to roll them.
I'm ready.
Gravity helps, but there's definitely an art to this job. The barrels have to land perfectly in the rack with the plug or bung pointed up. Otherwise, whiskey will leak out when the wood contracts in the winter cold.
Oh, so each one has to be positioned in the right spot. That's incredible. So you say if you're five barrels in, the bung has to be in a certain position to roll the right way?
Right.
I mean, these guys are making it look really easy, but it's not. Look how tight everything is. Everything's really tight here, too.
In a few years, the whiskey matures.
A little bit on the tip of your tongue, then let it ease.
But the next part is my favorite, tasting.
That's great. It's perfect. It's a truly iconic American product.
It doesn't matter where you find it. Every drop is made in Lynchburg, Tennessee.